Hey guys, welcome back to my channel, and yes, it's V4 Victory. So this is a look back at an sort of mini review of a mini series called V, the original mini series. This is from 1983. It's a two-part American mini series directed and written by Kenneth Johnson, and it came out in 1983. The original pitch for this particular show was actually not science fiction at all. It was supposed to be fascism, a kind of modern day for 1980s, fascism in the United States, based on a book, I believe, or inspired by a book called It Can't Happen Here, and it's sort of trying to emulate the rise of Nazi Germany, or maybe Mussolini's rule in Italy. So it was kind of inspired on those fronts. However, there was a big pitch for science fiction, with Star Wars being a big hit in the late 70s and early 80s. And then, of course, Star Trek, the movies, the rejuvenation of Star Trek as well, with 1982's Wrath of Khan. So science fiction was all the rage. So the network decided, and this was on ABC, I believe, if I can actually check that out. Yep, it was on ABC. So the network asked for a science fiction series. So the producers decided to make this story, change it to an alien invasion, and thus was born V. So, like I said, the V basically stands for Victory. One of the one of the older characters in this series, who is a I'm not really sure if he's from Auschwitz, but he is a Nazi concentration camp survivor who moved to the US. So he's the one who actually spray paints. Some kids were defaming some of the alien posters, and he takes the spray paint from them and does this symbol on them and says, V stands for Victory. So he tells them to go and tell all their friends. So that's how the kind of name comes for the thing. But however, I think a lot of people also know it as V for Visitors, because that's what they call the alien race of this. So the beginning of this particular television series, with this mini series, starts with the arrival of several large motherships, almost as big as cities, 50 of them, saucer-shaped spaceships that hover over. They arrive to Earth and they hover over major cities in the U.S., Asia, and a lot of other countries, and finally, they address in different languages that they would like to meet with the, I believe, the General Secretary of the United Nations, that they have been observing humanity, and they come in peace. They need our help, and they just want to extend their friendship. And in exchange for certain chemicals that they require, some materials for them, they are ready to offer their medical and scientific technology. So everything seems to be really good. The initial contact with the General Secretary, I believe. I thought he was an actor who I was familiar with, but no, I guess it just happens to be a little familiar face. Maybe because I've seen the series many times. So he meets with the Supreme Commander John, played by Richard Hurd, and you would also recognize him as Admiral Paris in Star Trek. I think mostly he's been in Star Trek TNG, or maybe only in Star Trek Voyager. He's Tom Paris's father. So he comes and addresses the public, and outwardly they look exactly like us. They mostly, the main differences are they have a resonance to their voice. So you can make out when they speak that this is a visitor. And the other difference is, the only other difference that they say is that they are very sensitive to bright light. So, and they prefer the cold. They're not used to too much heat. So they come and they say all they require is some chemicals and minerals, mainly from, taken from plants, chemical plants. So mainly it is like waste stuff for us. However, it is useful for them to actually help their ailing world, and which is supposed to be in orbiting the star Sirius. That was something that I did not remember until I started my rewatch of the particular series. a few years ago. So they reached out in friendship and they say they're willing to help us with their technology. So what could be better than that? So one by one, they start sending smaller spaceships to Earth, and initially it seems like there are way too many of the soldiers. I do like their uniform a lot. It's a very smart kind of uniform, which is mostly red with their logo. Again, inspired by the Nazi swastika, the Nazi version, not the Hindu version. I think it looks pretty smart, and it's really good for a little good look on screen. So the leader John and his deputy Diana, who's in charge of their major scientific researches, they start integrating themselves with human authorities, and pretty soon some people start to find out that all the major scientific minds in the U.S. it's mainly set in the U.S. so we'll go with American scientists are all either changing their minds about certain discoveries, or they seem to be like part of a conspiracy to give a bad name to the scientists, and slowly people start disappearing. Some people change their minds, and a couple of the reporters, they actually notice the differences. Like, for example, a couple of the scientists and one politician, they have changed their hands. If they were right-handed, they actually start writing with the left hand. So there is something sinister going on. Our main hero is television journalist, cameraman Michael Donovan, or Mike Donovan. And we have the Dr. Julian Parrish. And pretty soon, it's obvious to a lot of people that something else is going on. They start taking over a lot of the aspects of day-to-day life on Earth. And finally, when there are some minor attacks against some of the visitors, they start imposing a martial law. So we don't really know exactly what's happening, but there are some people who know that there's something going on. And Mike is the first person to sneak onto the mothership, and he videotapes Diana and another alien, another of the visitors. They are actually swallowing rodent's whole, and that is one of the biggest, attracting points to this particular series was, especially for those of us who were watching it at that time, is to watch these aliens taking live rats and swallow it. Of course, it's a gimmick, but it worked really well. And he also discovers that the aliens have these fake eyeballs, which they take off, and then he sees reptilian eyes. So he's attacked by one of them. He manages to escape. However, before he can broadcast his videotape, the network is shut down, and network goes off air rather, and he is a scapegoat for crimes that he has not committed, and he's on the run. He meets up with Julian Parrish and the Los Angeles resistance people, who have a lot of scientists and even other people like a cop and all that stuff. They understand that there is something going on. They've banded together in one of the underground tunnels, and they form their resistance cell. They take in like-minded people, they start storing weapons and other supplies, and they decide to uncover this particular thing for everyone else. However, a couple of things happen. One of the most interesting things is Robert Maxwell, who's an archaeologist. His daughter is attracted to Brian, who's one of the visitors. I think he's a lieutenant or something. And Diana basically tells him to impregnate this girl, because they are experimenting to see what would happen if a visitor and a human have a child. So she's fallen for him. He tricks her, that pretending that he's in love with her as well. And towards the end of the episode, end of the miniseries, we actually find out that she's pregnant and she's scared. So there's a lot of things that are the way that they slowly take over the the world's authorities is basically very reminiscent of how the Nazis took over Germany. And, you know, I think this is absolutely wonderfully done. I would have liked to see it instead of just two episodes. And when I say two episodes, it's an hour and a half per episode. It's a mini-series, so therefore it's an hour and a half each. I would have actually liked to see that done much in many more episodes, like maybe an 8-episode arc or something like that. Because it's really wonderful to see, or I wouldn't say wonderful, I would say really fascinating to see how they, you know, make people, change people's minds and take over the country without even much of a bloodshed. They just kill a few people who are onto them, but the rest of the things they actually take without much bloodshed. But there are people missing and stuff. Towards the end of it, when Mike sneaks onto the mothership for the second time, he is helped by Martin, and he finds out that they are harvesting, like, you know, humans for food. They put them into these chambers, I think, not cryogenic, but they are kind of storing them, and then they'll cut them down and process them for food for the visitors, as well as they are taking a lot of the Earth's supply of water without most people getting to know about it. So Mike finds out that Martin is part of the, they don't actually mention it, but he's actually part of the fifth column, which are people, which are not people, they are the visitors, do not agree with their leaders' plans to actually destroy the Earth, take out all the supplies and kill off humanity. They feel that either they can ask and share some of the supplies, or they can work out some other kind of, you know, other kind of joint venture or something like that. And so he offers to help Mike in his mission to actually fight against the alien visitors. So that's basically it. Towards the end, we find out that Robin is pregnant, and at this particular point, the visitors are almost virtually controlling all of the Earth, with some exceptions, but they do have a huge, they have a huge monopoly over the media outlets, and, like, you know, they control a lot of things, so it's not looking very good for the Earth at that particular point in time, at least for the Resistance. So that's it, that's the end of the particular miniseries, and next time we'll take a look at the final battle. Alright guys, I hope you do check out this particular mini-series. It's better. I mean, I know it's cheesy and all that stuff, but the mini-series definitely is much better than the television series. So do take a look at it. Thank you, and I'll catch you again soon.